viewers, welcome to civil engineering classes. Today's topic is meta cabinet. Now today we are going to discuss what are the things, being a civil engineer, what are the things that you should remember when you are providing a meta cabinet. Now you must have seen at your home also there is a small enclosure provided to your electricity meter. This is called the meta cabinet. Now this box could be of wooden material because at home you are going to provide a single meter or maybe two. But when you are providing it at your construction site where there will be number of meter or multiple meters will be provided, that time it is very economical to go for a metal meter panel. Because if you provide of wooden, then the cost of this wooden metal meter panel and also the maintenance of this panel becomes very costlier. So it becomes economical to provide metal electricity box meter panel. Now what are the things that you should remember when you are providing this panel? The first thing is, now this is your meter panel. This is the stand of it. And this is your plinth level. Now the height of meter panel from this plinth should be not less than 45 cm. The minimum height from the plinth level or the ground level to your meter panel should be 45 cm. Now this one, this panel, if it is of metal, the material of this panel is metal, then you should always paint it with primer and paint. The first point is, paint it with primer and paint to avoid the corrosion. Because if this metal panel gets corroded, then it can become very dangerous for your electricity connections. So the first thing you should take care that this metal panel is painted with primer and paint. The second thing is the size of this meter panel. Now here, if you see the meter panel, here there will be provision for meters. This will be the provision for meters, and here there will be provision for the busbar. Now the size of this meter panel should be always depend on the number of flats there in your building. Now each flat will contain one meter box, so depending on that you should calculate the size of the meter panel. Now let me tell you that one single meter panel or the single meter box contains or consume this size 0.28 square meter. The area consumed by a single meter box is 0.28 square meter, that is 3 square feet. A single meter box will consume area, that the minimum area that consume is 0.28 square meter, that is 3 square feet. According to this, you will have to calculate the area of the total meter panel. Now next thing you will see, there will be a door provided to this meter box. Every meter box will contain a door. Now you should always take care that these doors are always locked and no one other than the electrician or the meter reader coming from the department, no one other than these people shall be allowed to work in this meter panel area. So second thing, these doors of meter box should be always locked. And no one other than the electrician or the meter reader shall be allowed to to work in this area. The second thing is, this meter panel is mostly provided at the entrance to make it easy for the meter reading access. So it is always provided at the entrance. There will be an electrical room provided at the entrance, and in that room this meter panel will be provided. The next thing is, this meter box should be meter box. The correct name of the owner or the flat number should be mentioned. Now suppose this meter belongs to the ground floor first flat, then here you will have to provide the name, that is G101. Whatever the flat number you have provided to your flats, then you should mention here, then G102, then if it is on first floor, then FF101. This flat number that this meter box belongs to, that flat number should be clearly mentioned on the door of this meter box, so that whenever the meter reader is coming, he should easily identify which meter belongs to which flat. So the next point is flat number or owner name should be mentioned on door. And the last thing is, the wiring done or the connections done in this area, in this meter panel, should be very systematic and clean. There should not be any mess in these connections, and the wiring should be done very properly. So to avoid any kind of short circuit or any damage to these wires. So these are the things you should always remember while providing a meter panel. If you like this video, please like and subscribe our channel to learn more about the electrical work related to civil engineering. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.